Today marks the 155th anniversary of Juneteenth, the day slavery officially ended in the U.S. Now there's a push to make the day a national holiday on Capitol Hill. Senate Democrats said they will introduce a measure on the same day Texas Republican Senator John Cornyn announced he will advance a similar measure. The death of George Floyd has thrown the celebration into the national spotlight after weeks of protests sparked a national conversation about racism in our country's culture. Joining us to discuss, Marie Fischer. She's a member of Project 21, which is an African-American public policy group. And our panel of the day returns, Jennifer Nasur and Jack Kingston. Marie, welcome to the program. We've seen these racial tensions and calls for change across the country in recent weeks. How do you think that's impacting this year's Juneteenth celebrations?
Well, I think it's calling more attention to the Juneteenth celebration because when you talk to many Americans, both black and white, many have never heard of the celebration until this year. The average American probably has only heard of it in the last, say, 5 to 10 years. But this year, with all the issues with race, it is bringing to the forefront.
And how do you think people should be celebrating or recognizing today's Juneteenth celebration?
Well, when you think about it, Juneteenth marked the day that they announced in Galveston that the Civil War was ended and that the slaves were free. So I look at that way. I look at it as that was a day when they should have started healing in the United States from the Civil War. I think we should mark it the same way with all the racial tension. We need to start healing starting today with all the racial tension we have, because that's the only way we're going to be the United States of America once we heal.
We knew President Trump initially scheduled to host his rally in Tulsa, Oklahoma today. That's since been moved to tomorrow. Did you have an issue with the rally's initial date?
No, not at all.
Okay. And why is that?
Because, I mean, he's having a rally. He's the president of the United States. Mm-hmm. That's his prerogative.
All right. We have seen large corporations, including Target, Nike, and Twitter, they've made the date a company-wide holiday in recent weeks. This morning, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio says Juneteenth will be an official city and school holiday. And there's the tweet right there for you. Jennifer, do you think we'll continue to see more major corporations and potentially cities and states as well recognizing this as an official holiday?
I think so. And, you know, to go along with what Marie was saying, I mean, this should be a time of healing. And I think by recognizing it as a national holiday and for big corporations to get on board with it, it really does help and bring some notoriety to what had happened back in 1865 and the significance of it. And quite honestly, I really hate to see that we have Kamala Harris being joined by Ed Markey making a political statement on this, and then John Cornyn and the other corner. This should be a bipartisan legislation, a bipartisan bill, and bipartisan effort to start healing and to move the country forward.
I'm with you there. I think it does. We need both parties to come together and recognize it. We do know, of course, as I mentioned, President Trump headed to Tulsa for this big rally. Jack, do you think that this could be a good opportunity for the president to address the country's racial tensions that we're seeing right now?
Absolutely, because I can tell you that the things that he's doing so far, he's not getting any credit for. One of them that he announced this week was on police, tie federal grants into best training, best practices, also keep data on the police officers who are bad actors so that they are not rehired. He also, though, is going to be making more announcements about tying police in with social workers so that they can address some of the problems that they have in high crime areas. But beyond that, he also wants to talk about how do you get capital into the inner cities where there has been poverty for generations. How do you turn that around through capital? And also healthcare disparities in the inner city. He wants to address that. And then finally, education disparities. It's interesting, but you know, in the upper income areas, there is absolute school choice. You may go to the public school, but you could go to half a dozen private schools in your area. Most people in the inner city don't have that option when it comes to education. So the president has a lot of good things. Now, anytime you attach the name Trump to it, the Democrats already come out and say, oh, it's horrible. But if you look at these proposals on their face value, they are bipartisan, they are real, and they are serious. And I think he would have an opportunity. opportunity in Tulsa about that.
Yeah, we'll be tuning in. Newsmax is going to be broadcasting that live, so we'll be curious to see what he says. Marie, some final thoughts from you. I mean, we've seen some changes play out. Obviously, some statues, the conversation as to whether they should still stand, names of military bases. We've seen products change their brand logos completely. Is this just the start of it right now?
The start of it, but I don't agree with all of it. Because when you're erasing it, you're erasing history. And history is good, bad, ugly, pretty, but it's there for us to learn from it. And if you start erasing all of this, then we're bound to repeat a lot of this.
Yeah, something that should never, ever be repeated. So, you know, we continue to celebrate Juneteenth, and as we continue to see more cities and states recognizing today as an official holiday. Marie Fischer, a Project 21 member, thank you for coming on today's program and sharing your thoughts. We also had Jack Kingston and Jennifer Nasur, our panel of the day. We appreciate everyone continuing this healthy conversation. Thanks so much.
And thank you for having me.
Got it.